Good morning everyone. Today I am going to discuss about the computer organization subject unit 4. Coming to the topic. So topic is cache memory. So in this cache memory we having three types, that is associative mapping, direct mapping, set associative mapping. So these are the three mappings are available in the cache memory. So before going to discuss these three types, first of all we have to know what is mean by cache memory. So here I having the example diagram of the cache memory. Now I am going to explain about this. So if the active portion of the program, if the active portion of the program and the data are placed in the in a fast small memory, the average memory access time can be reduced. The average time access, the average memory access time can be reduced. Reducing the total execution time of the program, such a fast small memory is called a cache memory. So in the middle of the diagram, having the cache memory. So what is it mean? So it is a active portion of the program and a data. Okay, are placed in a fast. This cache memory is very fast, but a small memory. It is a very fast and small memory. The average memory access time can be reduced. So the average access time will be reduced. So when it is reduced, the total execution time of a program, such a fast small memory is called a cache memory. Okay. The cache memory access time is less than access time. So the cache memory access time is less than. So access time will be take the more time to access it. So but in the cache memory it access the less time compared to the access time of the main memory, which factors is from 5 to 11. So cache is only the small fraction of the size of memory. Cache is only a small fraction of size of main memory. So it means what? In the main memory, the cache memory is a small fraction of size. So it is placed between the CPU and the main memory. Okay. So the cache memory is only a small fraction of. A cache memory is a small fraction of size of main memory. It is located and it is placed between CPU and main memory. The CPU needs to access memory. The CPU needs to access memory. The cache is examined. If the word is found in the cache, it is read from the fast memory. So what is mean by CPU? Here in the right side of the diagram I having the CPU, at the left side of the diagram I having the main memory, in the middle I having the cache memory. Up to now we have discussed about the cache memory. Now I am talking about the CPU. The CPU needs to access a memory. The cache is examined. Okay, in order to access the memory, cache is examined. If the word is found in the cache, it is read from the fast memory. Okay. If the word addressed by the CPU is not found in the cache, so the CPU is addressing some word in the cache memory that is not found in the main memory accessed to read the word. Okay, so what the main theme of this CPU? The CPU will be need to access the cache memory. So whatever the words available in the cache memory, he need to access that information. Okay, but the first we are going to examine that cache memory. If any word is found in that cache, the CPU will be accessed. The CPU will be read from the fast memory. Fast memory is nothing but cache memory. Okay. So if the CPU doesn't found any word in the cache memory, the main memory will be reads the accessed to read the word. Okay, so that is the difference. Okay, so the performance of cache memory is frequently measured in terms of quality. So here the cache memory is measured in the performance of the cache memory is frequently measured in terms of quality called a hit ratio. When the CPU refers to memory, when the CPU refers to memory and finds the word in cache, so it is said to be produce a hit. If the word is not found in cache, it is in main memory and it commits a miss. Okay, so the performance of the cache memory is frequently the performance of the cache, how we define that cache memory performance is best, so how we measure that, so this performance of the cache memory is frequently measured in terms of quality called a hit ratio. So when the CPU refers to memory, it finds the word in cache, so it's said to be produce a hit. So the word is not found in cache, it is the main memory and it commits a miss. If the word is found for the CPU in the cache memory, then it is kind of that we can say it is a hit. So the number of hits, the ratio of number of hits divided by the total CPU reference to memory is the hit ratio. The average memory. So average, the average memory access time of a computer system. The average memory access time of a computer system can be improved. Considerably by use of a cache. So if the hit ratio is high, so that most of the time the CPU access the cache instead of main memory, the average access time is closer to the access time of the fast cache memory. Okay, so in this the transformation of data from main memory to cache memory is referred to as a mapping process. So we having three types of mapping procedures. One is associative mapping, direct mapping, set associative mapping. So I have example of this. Okay. So this is the example of the cache memory. Now only I discussed about this. So the main memory store, the main memory, how much it will be store? 32k words of 12 bits each. Okay, so the main memory stores 32k words into 12 bits each. The cache is capable of storing 512 of these words into 12 bits words at any given time. So for each word stored in cache, there is a duplicate copy in the main memory. So what is in the main memory? We are going to store the 32k words into 12 bits per each. So in the cache memory, we are capable to store 512 of these words any given time. For each word stored in cache, so there is a duplicate copy in the main memory. Okay. So if the CPU communicates with both the memories, so if first sends 15 bit, if first sends a 15 bit address to cache, first sends a 15 bit address to cache, if there is a hit, it means if there is a word found in the cache, that is, it means it is a hit, there is a hit, so the CPU accepts the 12 bit data from the cache. If there is a miss, the CPU reads the word from the main memory. If it is not found in the cache memory, the CPU will be reads from the main memory and the word is transformed to cache, and whatever the word is found, that is transformed to the cache memory. So this is the example of this cache memory. Next, coming to associative mapping. So what is mean by associative mapping? So the faster associative mapping, this is the example of the diagram mapping cache, and this is the octal diagram, and the faster and most flexible catch organization, the faster and most flexible catch organization uses an associative memory. So the most flexible catch organization uses an associative memory. This associative memory stores both address and content, I mean data of the memory word. What is the use of this associative memory, associative mapping? So it stores both address and data of a memory word. This permits any location in cache to store any word from the main memory. So it permits any location to store in a cache. So in the cache it permits any location to store any word from main memory. So in this diagram we shows three words presently stored in the cache. So the address value of 15 bits, the CPU address value is 15 bits, is shown in the 5 digit octal number, and its corresponding 12 bit word is shown a 4 digit octal numbers. Okay, so the address, so if you see this diagram, it shows the three words presently stored in the cache. The address value is, the CPU address value is 15 bits and 5 digit octal number and corresponding to 12 words shown in the 4 digit octal number. Okay, the CPU address is 15 bits is placed in the argument register. And associative memory, in the associative memory is searched for matching address, If the address is found, the corresponding 12 bit data is read and sent to the CPU, Okay. So here in this, if no match occurs, the main memory is accessed for words. So the address data pair is then transformed to the associative cache memory. So here if the cache is full, the address data pair must be displaced to make room for a pair that is need and not presently in the cache. The decisions as to what pair is replaced is determined from the replacement algorithm that the designer choose for the cache. For example, first in first out replacement policy. So this is called the associative mapping. Next, coming to direct mapping. So what is mean by direct mapping? So the CPU address, here I having the main memory and here I having the cache memory. Okay, so this is the octal address, here also we are having the octal address, and in this direct memory the CPU address of 15 bit, the CPU address is, so this is the 15 bits, is divided into two fields, 9 bits is the least significant bits, constitute the index field, and the remaining 6 bits from the tag field. Okay, we having the, in CPU address we having the 15 bits, this 15 bits is divided into two fields. So one field is taken 9 bits, 9 least significant bits that indicates as a index, and remaining 6 bits from the tag field. Okay, the main memory needs, this is the main memory that needs the address field that includes both the tag and the main memory needs an address that includes both the tag and indexed bits, both the tag and indexed bits. The number of bits in the indexed field, the number of bits in the indexed field is equal to number of address bits required to access the cache memory. Okay, so required to access the cache memory. For example, there are 2 power k. There are 2 power k words. There are 2 power k words. There is a 2 power k words in cache memory and 2 power n words in main memory. In this cache memory, we having the 2 power k words in the cache memory, in 2 power n words in main memory. The n bit address is divided into two fields, that is k bits for indexed field and n minus k bits for tag field. Okay. So, the direct mapping cache organization, direct mapping cache organization uses a n bit address to access the main memory and the k bit index to access cache memory. Okay. So, the internal organization of the words, the internal organization of words in the cache memory is shown in this diagram. So, each word in the cache memory consists of data word and associate tag. So, data word and associate tag. When a new word is first bought into the cache, the tag bit, here the tag bits are stored along side the data bits. Okay, data bits. When the CPU generates a memory request, the indexed field is used to access the cache memory. The tag field of the CPU address is compared with the tag in the word read from the cache memory. If the two tags matches, there is a hit and the desired data word is in cache. Okay. If there is no match, there is a miss and the required word is a read from main memory. So, it is stored in the cache together with the new tag. So, replacing the previous values. Okay. So, this is called the direct mapping. So, okay. Direct mapping. So, direct mapping cache organization. Direct mapping cache organization. The word at address 0. The word at address 0. 0 is presently stored in cache. Presently stored in cache. Index is 000. Index address is 000. Tag is 00. Data is 1200. Okay. Data is 1200. Suppose the CPU now wants to access the word at the address 0200. The index address is 00. So it is used to access the cache. The two tag are then compared. The cache tag is 00, but the address tag is 02. The address tag is 02, which does not produce a match. Okay. So, therefore, the main memory access the data accessed and the data word is 5670 is transferred to the CPU. The cache word at the address index address 000 is replaced with the tag of 0.2 and the data is 5670. Okay. So, disadvantages of this direct mapping cache organization is bit ratio can be dropped considerably. So, if two or more words whose addresses have the same index but different tags are accessed repeatedly. So, in the direct mapping cache with a block size of 8 words, the index field is now divided into two fields, that is block field and word field. So, in 512 word cache, there are 64 blocks of 8 words each, since 64 into 8 is equal to 512. The index field, is divided into two fields. One is a block field, another is a word field, block and word field. Okay. block two fields, block field and word field. Okay, so in a 512 word catch, in 512 word catch, so there are 64 bit, there are 64 blocks of 64 blocks. There is a 64 blocks of 8 words, 64 blocks of 8 words each. Since 64 into 8 is equal to 512, the block number is specified with a 6 bit field, and the word with in the within the block is word in, within the block is specified with a 3 bit field. The tag field store with the catch this common to all 8 words of the same block. Okay, of the same block. Every time a miss occurs, an entire block of the 8 word must be transformed from main memory to catch memory. So this task extra time, the bit ratio will likely improve with a larger block size because the sequential nature of computer programs. So next coming to set associative mapping. So why we are using set associative? The disadvantages of direct memory is that two words with the same index of their address but with a different tag value cannot reside in cache memory at the same time. So the set associative mapping is an improvement over the direct memory organizations in that each word of cache can store two or more words of memory under the same index address. So each data word is stored together with its tag, and the number of tag data items is one word of the cache is said to be form set. Okay. So this is in this set associative mapping I having the example. So in each this is the example. So each index address refers each index address refers to two data words and their associative tags. So each data requires 6 bits and each data word has 12 bits. So the word length is 26, 2 of 6 plus 12 is equal to 36 bits. So the index address of 9 bits can accommodate 512 words. The size of the cache memory is 512 into 36. It can accommodate 1024 words of main memory since each word of cache contains two data words. So in this word stores at the address, address of 01000 and 02000 of main memory at index address 000. Similarly, the word at addresses 02777 and 00777 are stored in the cache at index address at a place of 777. So when the CPU generates the memory request, the index value is used to access the cache tag field of the CPU address, is then compared with both the tag in the cache to determine if the cache occurs. So the comparison logic is run by the associative set. Of the tag in the set similar to an associative memory search. Thus the name was set associative. So the hit ratio will improved as size increases because more words with the same index but different tags can reside in cache. So an increase in the size set size increases number of bits in the word of the cache and requires more complex comparison logic. So when a miss occurs in a set associative cache and the set is full, it is necessary to replace one of the tag data items with a new value. The total common replacement algorithms are used. FIFO procedure selects for replacement the item that has been in the set of longer. The LRU means least recently used select or replacements the item that has been least recently used by the CPU. Both FIFO, first in first out, and least recently used or LRU can be implemented by adding a few extra bits in the each word of catch. Next we are having the writing into catch. So in the CPU, the CPU finds a word in the catch. During the read operation, the main memory the main memory is not involved in the transfer. So if the operation is write, there are two ways to that the system can proceed: write through need. So needed, the simplest and the most commonly used procedure is to update main memory with every memory write operations, with the cache memory being updated in parallel if it contains the word at the specified address. This is called a write through method. This next coming to advantage: the main memory always contains the same data as the cache. This characteristics is important in system with direct memory access transfer. So write back, only the cache location is updated during a write operation. So the location is then marked by a flag, so that later when the word is removed from the cache, it is copied into main memory. Okay, so this is called the writing into cache. Okay, next topic is the virtual memory. So what is mean by virtual memory? Okay, in the next class we will discuss about the virtual memory, and this is the diagram, and this is the address mapping using pages, and these are the page table of the associative memory. Next to last topic is the memory management hardware. So these are the different topics we will discuss in the next video class. Thank you everyone.